Hi, I'm Rami Tamimi, and welcome to my new office. This is the third iteration of my office space. I hope you guys like it. It's the same as the last one, except I got a new desk and I've gotten an upgraded setup. I brought in my 3D printer as well, so I'll be making videos about that in the future. Today we're going to be talking about text and the different types of text you can use in AutoCAD Civil 3D. Now there are two commands that you can use to bring in text to your drawing. The first one is the single line text command, and the second one is the multiline text command. Both of them are very similar, but one of them has just a slight advantage over the other. To add a text to your drawing, go to the Annotate tab, come down to Multiline Text, and we're going to start out by selecting the single line command. You can also just type in text in your keyboard. You'll be asked to specify the location of your text, so let's just put it here. You'll then be asked to put the rotation angle of your text. If you want it to just be straight horizontal, you can just say east, so that's what I will do. Hi, I am text. And then when you're done, just click away and then hit the escape button. And there you go, now you have some text in your drawing. Now this text can be changed and modified so that it's to your liking. If you want to change the content of your text, simply click on it twice and then you'll be given the option to edit it. We can just say, nice to meet you. All right, we've added more to our text. If you just select it once and look at the properties menu, you have a lot more options in terms of what you can do with it. If we wanted to change the color, we can just simply click on color and we have an array of different colors, or we can select a custom color if we wanted. So we really can choose whatever we want in terms of colors. If you wanted to change the layer, you can go in here and select which layer you want. If we go into the text tab under properties, right here you'll see content, and you can edit the content here if you want, although I just find it easier to double click on it and modify the text. Next you'll find style, and I'll go back to style in a minute. It's a little early to talk about it. Next you have annotative. Now annotative means that your text is going to come in at a custom size based off of the scale in your drawing. Now since annotative is turned on, you can see the annotative scale is 1 foot is equal to 100 feet, which if I look over here on the bottom of my scale, that is the scale that I'm set to. For fun, let's just change it to 200. This is still going to be at 1 inch is equal to 100 feet. However, if I were to create some new text, this is at 200 scale. The text now comes in at 200 scale. And you'll see why this is very important to keep in mind when you're typing in your text. The next option we see is justify, and this is simply one line text, so specifying where your text is isn't really going to make too big of a difference. It'll just kind of bounce it around, but really you could just move it back. It doesn't really do much as a single line. Justify is going to be more useful for the multi-text, which I'll show you later on in the video. Next, we have the paper text height, and this is what I was talking about with the annotative scale. Annotative always relies on the scale. So if you don't have a scale assigned to your text, you're just going to be giving it a text height. However, if you are assigning it a scale, then you need to give it a paper height. This will be the size of your scale on paper. If the annotative scale is off, then the only thing we care about is the actual height. So I keep mine on yes, and then I specify my annotative height. Notice how when I turned it back on, it switched to 1 in 100, and it gave me the paper text height at 0.04 rather than 0.08. If I change this back to 0.08, my text increases, and now it's the same size as the text on the 200 scale. It's always important to have your scale set first before you add any kind of text to your drawing. Next, the match orientation, which really isn't too useful in the model space. We'll probably talk about that in a later video when we go over paper space. The rotation. Let's say after you set your rotation, you don't like it, you want to rotate it at a different angle, you can change it here. Let's say I want it to point up, I can just say north, and now my text is looking up. If I want my text to be at a 45 degree angle, I can just type in 45, and now my text is at a 45 degree angle. Next, you have the width factor, and this will just stretch your text. So if you want it to be stretched out really wide, you would change the width factor. So if I just make from 1 to 2, now my text is stretched out. If I make it a 5, it's really stretched out. I'll just keep it at one. Next we have obliquing, and this will change the slanting of your text, kind of like to make it italics. Let's say I wanted to slant the text 45 degrees. I would just click here, type 45, and now my text is slanting at 45 degrees. And that's basically it. The rest of these are positioning and whether you want the text to be upside down or not, or backwards, which, I mean, if you have a need for that, you can do that. But more times than not, when you type something out, you're probably gonna want it to be upright and reading correctly. Now, some of the drawbacks of the single line text. I'm unable to make this more than one line. If I wanna make this more than one line, I have to have a separate text. And if you have a document with multiple lines, it's gonna be very difficult. Also, let's say I have some crazy long paragraph of words. I really can't bring this to stack on top of each other. Since the name is single line, you really can't put text on top of each other. It has to all be one line. Another limitation is, let's say I want to change the color of these four words. I want to make them red. But I want to make these three words green. Well, unfortunately, there's no way to specify certain words in certain colors. You have to make all of them the same. The properties must stay the same for all of this. So how do I change this and make it more custom? How can I stack the text and make it all one entity? This is when we use the multiline text command. Under the same tab, annotate, you're gonna come down here and select the multiline text. Or if you want the keyboard shortcut, it's just MText. The command will then ask you to draw a rectangle on the screen, so I'll draw it right here. And then it's gonna ask me to type something in. Hi, I am MText. And great, now we have some MText. Now the first advantage to MText is, just like the name implies, it has multiple lines. And if I were to double click on this and try to add more text, you can now have multiple lines added. Now this is at three lines right now, so why don't we make it just two lines? You just stretch the width of your box, and now you can have just two lines, or you can have a ton of lines, it's totally up to you. Additionally, when we go over to the Justify tab, we can now change this and it makes more sense. And on where we want these lines to read at. Do you want to read from the right? Do you want to read from the middle? The left? It's up to you. Let's make it center. That looks pretty nice. Something else you can do is select one line and make it a certain color. Let's make it green. And the second line, we can select it and make it magenta. There we go. Now we have two different colors for one MText. In the properties, you'll notice that in the same aspect of scaling and having paper text height, you have a few more options now. You have something called background mask, which if you turn on background mask, you can add an offset for your border and select a color. So let's make it white. Okay. And now we have a white background for our text. This can be great if you need your text to pop and stand out. You put a background behind it and it'll pop out much more clearly. I'm gonna just take this off because it's a little distracting. Something else you'll notice is the text frame. You can put a frame around your text. The nice thing about the text frame is it's also quite noticeable and makes the text pop out. It's not as drastic as the mask in the background. And if you wanted to add more MText, you can. I mean, I'm gonna create another one here. I'll type in, my name is Rami. And I want this to stand out more. Maybe I want the text height to be 0.16. So now the text height is bigger than everything else. I like this, but I want to change the font of this text. Well, if I double click on it and select the text, I get a text editor box now. You don't get this with normal text. Normal text, you don't get the text editor box, but with MText, you do. And that's where you can change a lot of different settings. So I want to change the font. I want to make it Times New Roman. There we go. And let's say I wanted to make it bold and italicized and underlined. I can do all that now. And then let's write one more MText just for fun. And let's say I want to make this much bigger than everything else. I'm gonna make this 0.24. Yeah, that's gonna be really big. I wanna center this. We're gonna put a big mask in the background. I want it to be red. Yeah, like that. We can put a border around it too, that's okay. I gotta find a really good font here. Yeah, okay, so now this is what I want. This is great. Now I've got big MText right here. Now after doing all this, I realized the last MText I did was phenomenal. It was perfect. I want everything to match this MText. I could go in here and change all of the MTexts that I have manually, or I can change the style of all of them and they will match the same style of one MText. To do this, type in the command style. And you'll be brought up with this window. Now I want to create a new style, so I'm going to click on new. We'll call this Rami's style. Okay. Now under Rami's style, I'm going to select a font. And this font, I'm going to select the show card Gothic, same one that we had before. I'm going to keep it annotative, but I want it to come in at 0.24 like my other one did. I don't need any special effects. We can keep the oblique angle. Actually, let's change the oblique angle to 45. Yeah, let's do that. You get a preview right here, so keep an eye on your preview. It'll give you a good insight on what your text will look like. And I think that looks good. So I'm gonna hit apply and close. Now I'm gonna select the MText that I have in my drawing, and I wanna change all of their styles to the Rami style. And look at that, now everything comes in the Rami style. I don't like how much the tilt is. I think 45 degree angle was a bit too much. The nice thing is I could just type in style again and select Rami style, and I can change this angle. Let's just make it 20 degrees. Okay, now everything updates and it says Rami style. You can go in here and still modify the color if you want to make it a different color. That's all good. But I know what you're thinking. The MText right now is looking great. You can change it and do whatever you want with it. But what about that poor text? I mean, look at it. You really can't do all this craziness with it. It's just so simple. Sometimes you wish that you didn't make it a text, that you had just made it MText to begin with. Well, lucky for you, there is a way to convert regular text into MText. To do this, you're gonna select your text, and in the ribbon, you're gonna go up to the Express Tools tab, and then under the text section, you're gonna see Convert to MText. You click on that, and now when you select your text, it is MText. If I were to click on it now, and I were to change the style to Rami style, now look at that. Our text is now Rami style. It's big, it's bold, it's just like the rest of them. So that's nice. That is how you bring in text to your drawing, modify it, change it, and personalize it to your liking. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, please like the video. I really appreciate it. Also, if you found my content to be enjoyable and you want to learn more, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel where I'll be putting out new videos in the future. If you have any questions on different topics or you're looking for a certain idea, leave a comment in the video. I respond to all the comments and I will try to make a video about it or answer your question for you. And with that, I will see you guys next time.